who rained on your parade, little Miss Sunshine.
I am not in the mood for this right now.
It's because you're not playing, I take it.
Like I haven't had a bad enough day already. Now I have to deal with you?
I know you're upset. But that dude Tommy's your brother. And brothers should always have each other's backs. And wipe that sourpuss look off your face. It's game time.
Champion tonight here at Stadium in Santa Clara for the college football playoff national championship game. It's the Michigan State Spartans and the Miami Hurricanes.
You okay, son?
Yeah, coach, I just...
Tommy, you all right, Tommy? We need some help over here. Hurry!
You got my back, right?
Of course. Always.
Then go out there and finish this thing.
One shot. That's all any of us ever really gets. Waited my whole life for my one shot at being a head coach. And here I am. This is your one shot to go out there and show the world who you are. Are you the guy who's going to lead this team to victory? Or are you going to be remembered as the guy who got caught up in the moment and let it all slip away? I know you're worried about Tommy. Sure, we all are.
Nah, que te calles, anciano.
The pressure, perhaps getting to this young Miami quarterback. They trail at the break. Now in this national championship game and what has been a tough defensive battle, and as we get ready for the second half kickoff, worth noting that Tommy Matthews does not appear to have exited the locker room with his team. We'll keep you updated as we receive more information. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They try and run on first down, but to no avail. Tackle for a 2-yard loss in the backfield. For Michigan State, now this is a football program that has been knocking on the door. They've been on this stage. Remember, they were in the college football playoff back in 2016. Couldn't get it done. The last time they did get it done, the last national championship for the Spartans, back in 1966. They would love to get another one here. 34-yard
line. Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Forget the run on third and one. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play. First and 10 now for the Spartans. Here's Young. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. The run got 4. Now they deal with a second and 6. Wade in the gun. Simpson reels it in over the middle. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Wade in the red zone here on first down. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Quarterbacks look all the time at manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage. Able to knock that one away.
On second down now, it's Young. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up. Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and eight.
Third and eight.
From the gun, Wade. And that is incomplete.
Wade's pass intended for
from the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Schottenheimer for the Spartans field goal. A 33-yard attempt.
And this one is right through. And the lead will increase to six now. It's 9-3. But looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps the deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you've pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. Perez. Throwing to start the drive. Launching. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Give him 32 on the play. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Looking to throw. Perez. And that's
okay, la puta.
It's a gain of six on the play, and it'll make it a second down. From the 35, back to work on second and four. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line.
He's tackled it.
The Hurricanes, of course, a three-time national champion back in the 80s, 83, 87, 89. They then added two more for good measure in 91 and 2001. But they haven't held that trophy since. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Now this throw caught left side. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Call that a gain of 11. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. A great effort there. There to make the grab. And his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead. After the departure of Tommy Matthews at the half, the offense able to regroup and put the football in the end zone.
Yeah, that's something they couldn't accomplish.
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And it's caught in the end zone. So it goes for 2 points on the fake and gives him a lead. So following the touchdown, here's the Miami kick team to send this one away. This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time, able to get three. That's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. To throw on second down. Wade, throw left side complete. That's Young. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Now third and five.
From the gun on third down. Wade, and the throw there going to be incomplete.
Intended for number.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Let's take another 25. Excellent move by Langford.
Come on, guys. Come on.
So dangerous with a football in his hands. Call that a return of 38. 37. Well, here's a first and 10 for Miami. Off play action. Perez flushed out right. He'll take a shot for the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
It leads to
line of scrimmage again, the 37, as they line up second and 10. He's going to go up top again. And that'll be incomplete. Perez took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
Brings up third down.
The offense on third down tonight, they've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is third and 10. He's going to let this go for the end zone. And it's in.
Vaya puto inútil, colega.
He had a great shot of picking that off in the end zone. It brings up fourth down.
It has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
And all the gamble. Puto panceta, tío.
It would have been a long field goal. The fake doesn't work out. And as a result, possession switches hands. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive. And he can't escape, and down he goes.
A loss of 7.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz. And even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
So they'll get 9 there as that sets them up better for third down. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Back to throw. Wade can't get away, and he's taken down. You never want to give up a sack. And from the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You talk about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Perez. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
To throw is Perez on first and 10. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Play there, 46 yards, and the Hurricanes add on to their advantage. Well, since he's coming to the game at quarterback, 2 trips into the end zone, and this offense starting to look remarkable. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And would you believe it? This is caught in the end zone. And the fake extra point works to extend their lead by 2. So following the touchdown, here's the Miami kick team to send this one away. Pulls it in at the 13. And a penalty marker's down on the field. And they might be backing up a bit here to start the drive. Yeah, this is going to put them back with a not great field position.
So they really got 0 benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return. Then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
Now he dumps this off over the middle. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line.
On first down, Wade. And he's going to be brought down here in the backfield.
A loss of 6 yards. It's second down.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Operating from the gun, Wade. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. On fourth down, Wade. Blitz coming and down he goes. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
The Hurricanes now first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Woods, and he's going to take this down to about the 17. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's third and 2 now.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front and then maybe a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. It's a gain of 4, and that should just about seal the deal.
Well, partner, none of these runs individually have added up to a whole lot.
Now, 3 plays, all 3 short runs, but together, a first down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the narrative changes when you string them together.
One final kneel down here as it comes inside the 42nd mark, and that should be enough to put this one on ice. Second down, it's Woods. And power running here down to the 6-yard line. 8 yards there on the carry, and now they're left with a much more manageable 3rd and 3.
That's a gain of 8. Makes it 3rd and 3. Tonight.
So that'll do it. For the first time since 2001, the Miami Hurricanes are the national champions. And celebration time on that sideline. It took a change in quarterback. His thoughts will turn to the condition of Tommy Matthews. But for now, jubilation as they are the national champions.
Well, Tommy's injury certainly was a setback.
I think there's only one individual.
Man, promise me one thing.
Anything.
That you'll come back next year and make him win the championship together.
Next year? You know I will, brother. Together.
How could you possibly make that decision after the title game? Is Tommy even going to be able to play?
Yeah, I spoke with his doctor. Valve replacement surgery was great. He's going to be right as rain.
Just don't understand.
I know this is hard for you. It's hard for you to process, and I hope you believe me when I say that I take no joy in making this decision. But I stand firmly behind it because, frankly, Tommy's a better fit for the offense.
Well, what does this mean for me?
Well, it It means that you are at a monumental crossroads in your life, and you've got two choices. You can enter the draft, and based on what you did last year, I'd say you'd be lucky to get picked in the third round. But realistically, you're looking at a late-round selection, if at all.
Jeez, don't sugarcoat it for me.
Well, I'm trying to be open and honest with you. From this moment forward, I'm giving it to you as I would my own beloved son.
And my other choice?
Well, the way I see it, you got too much raw athleticism to waste sitting on the bench. Your talent is a true gift. And it's one that I'm going to give you the opportunity to show it to the world.
And how's that?
You get to pick a new position on offense and get your heartbreak kids thing going back again.
I appreciate the faith, coach, but if I'm going to play QB at the next level,
pero que te folles, viejo.
That's probably true.
So the NFL Combine, I spent so much time preparing for it. But some things, you can't ever say you're fully ready for. That's how the week felt for me. No. Oh, this cannot be happening. Okay. Oh, man. Okay. And I don't mean to sound ungrateful, but they're a little damp. They're like really damp. Did you go swimming in these?
Thought you said you were a fan. If you were, then you'd know I just ran my annual Run Rich Run 40 for charity.
Right. Right, how'd it go?
Let's just say my days of keeping up with Saquon Barkley are behind me. Maybe you'll fare better than I did out there.
What was your time?
5.98, baby.
Well, I can't do any worse. I've seen statues move faster than that.
All right, well, I want you to go out there and post a time of at least 4.6. Think you could swing that?
With as much adrenaline as I have coursing through my veins right now from trying to find my cleats, there's no way I don't beat the combine record. I'll tell you what, I'll be even faster. Just watch.
Now that is what I like to hear. Welcome to another exciting edition of the NFL Scouting Combine. I'm Rich Eisen, and I'll be your tour guide as we meet the next crop of elite NFL talent. We're going to start things off with my personal favorite, the event that can break the spirit of any man.
Pero cómo vas a brindar con esas zapatillas, tú pareces un payaso.
First up, we've got one half of America's darlings, the Heartbreak Kids. An intriguing draft prospect, to say the least. We'll see him up next for the skills portion of this year's NFL Scouting Combine.
Okay. On the ready.
Today had a little bit of it all. Select few guys who may have just cemented their place as one of the top picks in the upcoming NFL draft. Until next time, I'm Rich Eisen. Welcome to the 2020 NFL draft. Sure, the experts have Welcome back to the first round of the 2020. What a phenomenal pick. This kid has shown some elite abilities on the field.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. Tutorial review your player card. Tutorial full season experience. You can't catch my drift. Tutorial continue and ready.
Damn, Kane, you
my player card.
I'm balanced land trying to keep the people stable the way I feel. I might it all up the way you feel. You might do it for the bug. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me. I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry. Don't let alibi.
Continue. My player card.
This is the player card. Here you can see your strengths and weaknesses by looking at your archetype. This is your development trait. Superstar and superstar.
Edit player.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire.
At your first training camp, who helped you adjust to NFL life?
No matter how ready you think you are, nothing really prepares you for the big leagues. So I appreciated having him as a guide, but I didn't realize just how much impact it would have over the course of my rookie year, on and off the field.
Well, we finally get to see at least one of our beloved Heartbreak Kids in action on the field. Look, I'm a founding member of the Heartbreaker fan club, going all the way back to their high school days. So, needless to say, I for one have been dying to see them step onto an NFL field and show everyone what they can do since we last saw them lighting the world on fire in the college ranks. But as excited...
Entering main menu screen, ultimate team, face of the franchise.